What's good, y'all? It's your boy Ross back at again with another video. So we're gonna check out Roman Reigns in Theory promo. Who's your daddy? Full segment. This should be an interesting one, man. I want to see Roman Reigns and Austin Theory, their interaction. We saw what happened to Austin and Brock. We saw their interaction on Friday Night SmackDown. Austin Theory was sent to the gulags at the end of SmackDown. He was able to find his way out the gulag. So the question will be, will Roman send Austin Theory to the gulags himself in this promo segment? I don't know. We will see. Appreciate all the love and support you guys been showing on the channel. We're almost at 90K. So thank you so much for all the love and support. Let's see what the Tribal Chief has to say.
He just loves to piss on everyone's parade. And I'm
I see Roman with the low top 11s.
Brock!
I see you, Roman. The low 11s, low top 11s.
When Randy Couture was the greatest MMA heavyweight of all time, who ruined that party? Brock Lesnar. When the Undertaker.
One thing I always loved about Paul Heyman, he understands. He can build up the opponent. He knows how to build up the opponent. And that's always good. Like, he builds up the opponent as a viable threat to the champion or whoever he's with. And I've always loved that about Paul. You got to appreciate someone that can talk somebody up, but also talk down to them as well. I love that. I love that so much about Paul.
Was 21-0 at WrestleMania. Who ruined that party? Brock Lesnar. When John Cena was running around.
I was hoping he was going to talk about the John Cena destruction at SummerSlam. Oh, so great.
With all the hustle, loyalty, and respect. Who took him to Suplex City and burst that bubble? Brock Lesnar. And now, Brock Lesnar looks at this Saturday as day number 699, and he says, oh, I'm going to ruin the party for Roman Reigns.
I don't know, man.
It's why my tribal chief takes it so personally. Roman Reigns is tired of Brock Lesnar's legacy being tied into the legacy of the greatest of all time, Roman Reigns. You think of the Knicks, you think of the Celtics, you think of the Yankees, you think of the Red Sox, you think of Hogan, you think of Macho Man, you think of Stone Cold, you think of The Rock. Well, when you think of Roman Reigns, you will no longer after Saturday ever have to think of Brock Lesnar.
I actually want to say, if you really want to break it down, yeah. Roman's, I guess, ultimate rival has been Brock Lesnar. When you really think about it, like actually think about the way he broke that down, some would say it's Seth, but I don't think it's Seth. Even though they've had a very good rivalry, you would think it would be Seth. It probably should be Seth, but it's not. It's Brock and Roman. It's Brock and Roman. That's that. When you look back on this 10, 15 years from now, 20 years from now, we'll think of Roman Reigns and Brock having their rivalry. Was it good? Most of it wasn't that good, like match-wise. It's only like a few matches so far that were actually worth watching, like worthwhile. The build-up's probably been more better than the actual matches. But when you think of rivalries, you may have to put them, if they do a future documentary, you would have to probably put Roman and Brock in that category.
Again, because the suplexorcist is going to exercise the demon of Brock Lesnar out of the legacy of Roman Reigns.
Love his promo skills.
We're sick of Brock Lesnar's name. We're sick of Brock Lesnar riding on the coattails of the greatness of Roman Reigns. It's time for Brock to go back to Saskatchewan and slaughter a bunch of hogs. So here's what's going to happen. Anything Roman Reigns needs to do.
I'm really interested in what they do here. They have that stipulation. They can make this probably their best match. Even though it's not technically a wrestling match. If they want to end it right, this will be the best way to do it. They need to go all out. And it needs to be utter chaos and destruction. I'm all for the flaming tables. I doubt it'll happen. That's fine. But you get what I'm saying. Destruction, chaos. That's the only way this match needs to end.
Brock Lesnar down for the count of 10. And in this, their very last match ever together, Roman Reigns will finally rid himself of Brock Lesnar. Which is why my tribal chief has nothing to say tonight. Because my tribal chief, Roman Reigns, cannot stand the sound of the name Brock Lesnar. And after this Saturday night at SummerSlam, Brock Lesnar, you won't be able to stand at all.
I like how he's listening to the crowd saying Super C. Uh-oh. Oh, boy.
That's what you were thinking. Brock and Roman Reigns, the X Factor for this Saturday, makes an appearance.
Mr. Money in the Bank himself.
You know what's so funny to me?
Bro, I like how he always gives him that same look. He knows he's Money in the Bank winner, but he just gives him like, what are you doing? He gives him like, the fuck is this guy doing?
What's so funny to me is the Bloodline talks a lot, but they seem to have forgotten the most important detail about SummerSlam.
Bro, it's that look of...
You see, at SummerSlam, I'm not only going to take back my United States Championship from the almighty Bobby Lashley, but I'm also going to walk down to this ring just like this. Cash in my Money in the Bank contract. It doesn't matter if it's Brock Lesnar or Roman Reigns, because I will be the new undisputed WWE Universal Champion.
I like how the briefcase is still dented up from his beating he received on Friday. Oh my God, bro. Brock beat the hell out of him with his own briefcase. I want to see what Roman's about to say here, bro.
You just gonna stop right there? If you're gonna come into my arena, at least step foot in my ring and acknowledge your tribal chief.
Acknowledge me, bro. Come on. I like someone in the crowd. Go ahead, acknowledge him. Get your ass beat again. Acknowledge him. Come on.
Yeah, looks like he's mulling it over.
Come on.
Come on.
Don't be scared now.
No way. I don't think this is a good idea for Theory at all. We saw what happened to Theory Friday night on SmackDown when he encountered the
crowd chanting, don't be scared. Don't be scared.
Beast incarnate firsthand. And that was one-on-one. You gotta give Theory credit. The kid's got guts.
he's nervous, you know what I'm saying? New York, take it easy on him. He's a little nervous. It's his first time, all right? I get it. Hey. Wise man, we like him, right? We like him.
He's all right.
Bro, they are making this man like a joke. He's cool. Bro, this is so crazy. He's the Money in the Bank winner, right? But you have these two guys that had this historic, well, I wouldn't say historic, but this long rivalry. They're about to try to kill each other. You got him trying to, you know, weasel his way into the situation. And they both look at him as a joke. Like, move around, little kid. The adults are talking.
I can appreciate what you're trying to do, but let's be honest here. You have no clue what you're doing with that briefcase right now. As a matter of fact, I think he needs a wise man. You need somebody to counsel you. Here, I'll be that guy for the night, all right? Here's some words of wisdom for you, Theory. I want you to start looking around. I want you to analyze this situation here, you understand? Your daddy's not here anymore.
Oh! Oh, holy! Oh! Oh! Oh, oh, oh! Oh my yo! Oh my yo! Oh! That was cold. That was good. That I had to take my headset off. That was good. That was told, yo, daddy not here no more, a.k.a. Vince. This is Vince's boy. Your daddy's not here no more, bro. Oh, my God, we got to run that back. That was tough.
Your daddy's not here anymore.
Oh, that was good. That was good. Oh!
This is my ring.
Oh, daddy's gone. This is so good. This is good, bro. He's like, daddy's gone. Daddy's gone, bro.
And you heard him.
Who's your? I love the New York crowd. Y'all show it. Who's your daddy? This is so good.
Daddy's gone.
Oh, no, Theory.
I'll tell you who his daddy is, because if he keeps messing up, the tribal chief is going to be his daddy. Because we want you to understand.
Oh my God, this is so good. This is so fuck. I love this. Oh, this was good, bro. This is such a good segment, bro. We gotta run this back just a little
bit
more.
I'll tell you who his daddy is, because if he keeps messing up, the tribal chief is gonna be his daddy. But we don't want that, because we want you to understand the situation here.
This is good.
I run the garden now.
Oh, the pat on the back, bro.
Stern warning delivered by the tribal chief.
Oh.
For the disrespect for Jey Uso. What? Step up. I don't need this.
Oh, bro, this is good, dog.
Chief showing restraint.
The crowd! I love it! This is so good, bro.
He's clearly not sweating Theory. But you have to ask the question. Roman Reigns brought up a great point. Does Theory truly know what he's doing with that briefcase? You know, does know what he's doing. The tribal chief.
This is great, bro. This whole segment was fantastic. I enjoy this entire fucking segment, bro. This is fun. That was good. The whole your daddy's gone now, referencing Vince. I run the show. Crowd going, who's your daddy? This was great. This was so goddamn great, man. Oh, WWE, bro. I love when you do stuff like this. This was cool. And here's the funny thing, man. Theory, he's just out there in no man's land, bro. He got destroyed by Brock. He got eviscerated on the microphone here. Oh, man. I'm going to be honest with you. I don't see him winning. If he does cash in, I still find him. I can see him losing, bro. They just... both Brock and Roman, respectively, disrespected this man on separate shows. So, oh, man, this was great, man. Comment down below. Let me know, who is Austin Theory's daddy now? Like, who's his dad now? Let me know. We got to find Austin Theory's dad because he needs him right now. I appreciate all the love and support. Road to 90K. Appreciate y'all kicking with me. See y'all next one. Peace.